HIV transmission through kissing. Hello folks, it's Mark Medicals here teaching you about HIV infection like HIV treatment and HIV symptoms. In this video, you will learn about the following. 1. How quickly can HIV be transmitted? 2. What happens if you kiss someone with HIV? 3. How much saliva is needed to transmit HIV? 4. HIV transmission through kissing. Before I answer this question, I need to remind you that most of your questions could be already answered in one of our 1000 videos on this channel. Please go through our videos and get your answers. Also, check in the description section below this video for our most liked videos. Alright, let us dive in and get answers. 1. How quickly can HIV be transmitted? According to my last videos, there is more than 96% risk of getting infected from HIV-infected blood transfusion, and less than 2 out of 100 people will contract HIV from unprotected intercourse. An important note is that, newly infected people will quickly infect you with HIV in just 10 to 33 days when most of the HIV testing kits are not 100% accurate. So, a person can test negative but still infect you with HIV. Any HIV infection is determined by the extent of exposure, viral load of your partner being on HIV treatment or not, route of HIV exposure, and so many other factors we have been mentioning in our previous videos. 2. What happens if you kiss someone with HIV? There are many diseases which you can contract through kissing. According to www.london-docstors-clinic.co.uk, these diseases include herpes virus infections, glandular fever, cold sores, meningitis, influenza, and syphilis. Some studies have also associated mouth and throat cancer to be caused by germs spread through kissing. Can you get HIV from kissing? The answer is no and yes. Let us continue and see how. 3. HIV transmission through kissing. According to many studies done and reported, HIV is not transmitted through kissing because saliva kills or inactivates the virus. Studies have shown that, if HIV-infected CD4 cells are placed into saliva, the cells will swell and burst, thus killing the HIV particles instantly. This is because the pH of saliva is not favorable for the virus. Also, there is an enzyme in saliva that instantly kills HIV, a reason HIV is absent in the saliva of people living with HIV. 4. How much saliva is needed to transmit HIV? I know there are myths around there saying that you need to swallow more than 2 liters of saliva to get infected. I have not seen any study supporting that evidence. What is clear is that, if both you and your partner have sores in the mouth and there is an exchange of blood, then definitely, you could be at risk of HIV. Actually, the higher the amount of saliva, the higher the chances of destroying the virus.